This is a podcast from the London Accordion Orchestra. For more information, visit our website at www.londonao.co.uk. Hello, I'm Sam Cullen. In this episode, I will be talking to special guests that participated in GAPO, the Global Accordion Project Orchestra. This was an idea that came at the start of the lockdown period in March 2020. Musical director of the London Accordion Orchestra and composer Ian Watson and myself discussed the almost impossible idea of collating videos and audio of accordion players from around the world to record themselves in their own home whilst isolating. Working with Ian's publisher, Amusico, we decided that piece would be a fitting orchestral work to record and perform virtually. The parts were emailed to players from Germany, Ireland, France, Switzerland, the UK, America, Russia, Ukraine, the Netherlands and New Zealand. Here is a clip of the recording by the GAPO players. I want to find out from the participants that played on the track what they thought of the project. And Yvonne from Ireland got back in touch. Yvonne, thank you very much for being on the podcast. When you heard about the project, what were your initial thoughts on what this might look and sound like?
My initial thought on the look of it was exactly how it turned out, in that I had seen projects similar to that online with some of the major orchestras. So I had guessed that it would more or less be what it turned out to be. But I just thought that the quality of the production on your one was really, really good. I wasn't expecting it to be as professional looking as it ended up being. With regard to the sound, I mean, I presumed it would be a good sound because the standard of the orchestra is so high. The only thing I suppose I did think of was, well, will everybody be as good as the players of the LAO? How would the tuning work if you had people from different countries who would use different brands of accordion and different tuning methods? I wondered, you know, would that work out okay? But of course it did. It was fantastic. Really wanted to get involved with the project because I felt that, to be honest with you, it'd be the only chance I'd ever get to play with the LAO as we live in a different country. And of course, the orchestra has such a high standard. It's a pleasure and an honour to play with the orchestra in any way, shape or form. So well done to everybody involved. And it's lovely to have and to look back on. And I'm really looking forward to hearing the latest project.
Thank you, Yvonne. You run your own music school in Ireland. What projects have you been doing since this lockdown?
There are three different strands to our private music school that we run. We teach from home. That involves teaching both piano and accordion. We also teach in schools and we also have the Accora Orchestra. So once the lockdown happened, all of the schools were closed, so that was gone completely and there's nothing really that can be done in that context. With regard to the private teaching, we've been very lucky in that we are teaching online. We're using Zoom for that and we find it very good mostly. We find that around the grade 3, grade 4 standard, the middle of the road, it's great because, you know, they know where everything is on their instrument. They can read the music. You're just giving them the instructions. They can understand what you're saying and it's great, and it's great for them. For beginners, it's not so good because if they don't really know where the notes are on their instrument, they find it very difficult to follow what you're saying. Their reading ability wouldn't be great either. And then for the higher grade, grade 7, grade 8, it's kind of a bit of a disaster really, because
at that level, you're looking really for dynamics articulation, which can't be heard through Zoom. So it's really correcting mistakes and rhythms and note values. And you would hope nearly at that level that they'd be able to do that themselves. But, you know, it's working from that point of view. We had a number of students who didn't take up the offer of online lessons for various reasons. Some parents lost their jobs. Other households had very poor fibre broadband or no broadband, and any bit of broadband they had, they needed for working from home or schoolwork. So that didn't work out there. But for the students that did take it on, the parents were delighted that there was one activity still going, because obviously with lockdown, everything else was cancelled. So at least they had some activity that they could be doing at home. Most of the students, we have great improvement over the last number of weeks. I think there's a number of reasons for that, one of them being time. So they're far less stressed. The children and teenagers that we teach look so much more healthy. They look so less stressed about everything, and they have time to enjoy their instrument. They also don't find it so much of a chore. They're not trying to squeeze it in between everything else. So huge improvement overall, which we are really delighted with. We can't get over that. So that's a huge positive that has come from online teaching for us anyway.
How have the members of your orchestra participated from their homes?
With regard to the orchestra then, we've done one project like the Global Accordion Project, but we've done it with Over the Rainbow, because most of the people who wanted to do it were the younger members of the orchestra. All the older ones wanted to do your project, so they went and did that. So our project that we did with the little ones, we used Over the Rainbow. So they were all delighted with that and love looking at themselves at videos, on video and on Facebook and all the different platforms that it's gone on. Now, we've had a few other, like Cavan County Council, the Arts Department, and that they've picked up on it. A couple of the local newspapers and radio stations have also picked up on it and have shared it on their page as well. So that's very positive from the younger children's point of view. We also are holding Zoom concerts on a Friday evening, and we've done one quiz, which was great fun. But the Zoom concerts work on the basis that a link is sent out through the orchestra WhatsApp to everybody in the orchestra. So you can come to the concert as a participant, or you can come as a spectator. So we round up a few people each week to play, and the rest of the people just come in and look, and there's all the rounds of applause and all the chat, and children are only delighted to see each other, because I suppose if they're homeschooling, a lot of the time they're doing it without Zoom, without visuals. So to see their friends is great. They just love it, and they're hi to each other, which is lovely. It's really lovely to see. On another note, what we decided as an orchestra, so all the teachers put a proposal to our committee, our organising committee, that the teachers would give free lessons to the grade three or below. Now, the main reason for this was because of the beginners. Our beginners started last September. So we have mini musicians, we have recorders, and we have beginner accordions. Now, the recorder is only really used as an in-between the mini musicians and accordion, because some of them are just that little bit too physically small to actually play the accordion. But we just find it's a great way to introduce them to reading music and following rhythms and stuff. Before that, we weren't taking children until they were 7 or 8, until they could hold an instrument. But we were finding at that stage they had already had so many activities on the go that they wouldn't have had time to take up orchestra. So that was the reasoning behind the mini musicians and recorders and so on. So because they're not with us that long, we thought if they had a really long break, it would affect them coming back to us. They'd get used to not practicing, they would get used to not having to go. So we thought it would be a great way to keep the interest going, which it has. Parents are very, very grateful that we are doing these for free. On an interesting note is that sometimes they are group lessons. So sometimes they forget to, they don't see the text or they don't see the email because they haven't put it in their phones or on, you know, alarms or anything like that. It doesn't really happen for our private students who pay by the term. If they have a lesson at a certain time of the day, 99 times out of 100, they will be there. Or if they can't be there, they'll have text previously to ask to reschedule the lesson. So it's an interesting one, you know, for debate. Because it's free, do they value it less? And it's just an interesting one to think about. So I think that's about it, really. And thanks for asking me to do this interview or podcast. And I'm really looking forward to hearing our latest global project, which is debuting over the weekend. So thank you very much and love to all in the London Accordion Orchestra. Bye.
Thank you to Yvonne in Ireland. And now on to the next guest, a member of the Nuremberg Accordion Orchestra and the Nuremberg Accordion Ensemble. Marco, thanks for being on the podcast. When the invitation to join GAPA was broadcast, Germany had already started the lockdown process for about a week. When you saw that video, what were your expectations before recording the music?
Hi Sam, thank you for your question. I hadn't so large expectations. I was only happy to play music, and it was really a nice and welcome diversion to take part in this project during this terrible and confusing time. And it was great to send a musical sign into the world as a member of the Global Accordion Project Orchestra and to encourage other accordionists and musicians all over the world not to give up.
That's really positive, and you've picked up on the idea of collaborating with other musicians to create something new and different. Thank you. Once the final music video came out, you messaged us, like so many others, with some wonderful feedback about the whole project. Was there anything in particular that was challenging for you, and have you gained anything for your own future online music projects?
Yes. If you make such a video project, it's important that the keyboard of the accordion and your hands and yourself are completely visible while you are recording your video. Otherwise, the viewer of the video can't understand what you are doing and could be quickly bored. And furthermore, it makes the recording so much easier if you have a click track for the tempo.
That is great advice, as both Ian and I found this project was a steep learning curve to anything we'd done before. Thank you, Marco. My final question is for Julie Luck, leader of the London Accordion Orchestra and conductor of London Accordion Players. I should also mention that you are the leader for this particular virtual online orchestra. This is a concept which is new to both of us, which has its challenges but also new opportunities. What will you take from this experience as a player when you are usually teaching, conducting or playing in a room full of people?
Thanks, Sam. I think being part of a project like this has reinforced what I already knew about the power of music to bring people together and that fantastic sense of fulfillment you get coming together with other people to perform. I suppose the obvious difference with a project like this is that you have to wait a while from playing your part on your own to hearing the finished version. And that sense of achievement you get from knowing that the audience have enjoyed your performance is normally a much more instant thing. But with a project like this, there's a much greater sense of anticipation and in some ways impatience and having to wait to hear the final result. I think as a player, it can also make you quite self-critical. So it makes you realise you're not just playing in the moment as you normally would, but playing and recording something that's going to be watched and listened to over and over again. I feel really lucky to have been part of something like this that brings accordionists together from all over the world, but it's definitely made me realise that I can't wait to get back to be able to play with other people again in real time.
Thank you to the guests on this Gappo episode and to the accordion players and percussionists that participated, of which there were over 100 people. That was the first project track titled Peace, and since April we have invited more players to participate in another recording project, this time using a short piece written by Ian and once again performed by members of the Global Accordion Project Orchestra, titled Song Without Words. Here is a short clip of the music. Was a clip of Song Without Words written by Ian Watson and performed by members of the Global Accordion Project Orchestra. After creating two videos that are available to watch online, we have launched our new Gappo adventure called Horizon. We will commission Ian Watson, our musical director and composer, to write a new piece specially for Gappo. Ian is a professional accordionist, and due to the pandemic, most of his performances have been cancelled. So he will write this new commission called Horizon over June 2020. You can find further details of the project on our Facebook page if you would like to be involved in the world premiere. Thanks for listening, and until next time, it's goodbye from us.
You've been listening to the London Accordion Orchestra podcast. For more information, visit our website, www.londonao.co.uk.